within 3/4 mile. Turn right onto Butterfield Road.
DC News, the G19 gets put on notice. New guns from Ruger and ATI, and TGC raises money for Texas. Laser Max offers some of the most rugged aiming assist devices around, with a low profile option such as their guide rod lasers. You can keep that factory look or even add attack light without taking up rail space with the laser. Combining over 25 years of experience with modern materials and technology, these things are built to last. Available in red, infrared, and green, many popular handguns. To learn more, head over to lasermax.com. Welcome back to another episode of TGC News, the only gun news show that covers things you actually care about. My name is John Pass. Boys and girls, it is the last week you get to join in on the TGC Bacon Bash giveaway. It ends this Friday, the 15th of September. For those of you living under a rock, I'm giving away nearly $4,000 worth of stuff, including a POF Revolution 308 rifle and a trip to Alabama to take your new rifle hunting along with me.
Turn right onto Butterfield Road.
It's going to be incredible. Full details can be found at tgcgear.com. Now, the news. Smith & Wesson has been relatively quiet in recent months, not really introducing anything special, just a couple revolvers that didn't really move the needle for me.
In 2.2 miles. Exit onto State Route 38 West.
I suspect they were waiting until SHOT Show to release things, but it was until this past weekend rolled around and the M&P 2.0 compact leaked. Now, to be clear, the M&P line of pistols has always had a standard full-size gun and a subcompact, but never something in the middle. Until now. After years of Glock 19 sales doing extremely well, Smith & Wesson got their crap together and released a mid-size gun. And prior to this, the only 2.0 guns were full-size. Let's hit the specs on this one. 4-inch barrel, shortened grip blades, 4 grip panels, 2 15-round magazines, the 2.0 texturing and trigger, and you can also get these with or without an ambi safety. They also come with 2 adapters so that you can run the full-size 17-round magazines in these guns as well. So essentially what you have here is a direct competitor for the Glock 19, just shy of 30 years late. Be sure, M&Ps have always gone head-to-head with Glock. Let's not kid ourselves about that. But it is very interesting that Smith waited this long to release a gun this size. Yes, I know it's available in Corey Smith & Wesson, but I encourage you all to just let that cartridge die peacefully. Personally, I can't wait to try and get my hands on one of these and compare it to the other models out there. I'm a huge fan of the M&P ergonomics, so this should be a welcome addition to the family. Because this was leaked, Smith & Wesson has been fairly quiet about it. However, Brownells is smart enough to strike when the iron is hot and already has the item listed for sale on their website at $499 for pre-order. I'm curious to see what you guys think. Is this too little too late, or are you chomping at the bit to get one of these for yourself? Let me know down in the comments. And in Because We Can News, Ruger has expanded the rimfire side of things once again on their Mark IV line with 2 new pistols. In case you're unfamiliar, the Mark IV came out almost a year ago and is probably one of the best rimfire pistols on the market because of one feature: the easiest takedown on any gun that I've seen in a single round. It's incredible. Anyway, the 2 new models are the standard, which is a new take on the classic look of the Mark I and features that distinct tapered barrel and raked grip angle that the Mark series has been known for. These will be available in 2 different barrel lengths, 0.75 and 6 inches. And they've also added the M4 Tactical, which is different than the 2245 Tactical, in that it offers the same classic grip angle that I just mentioned. It also comes with a Picatinny rail on the top and on the bottom of the barrel. All of the other features are similar to the previous versions of the Mark IV. 10-round mags, decent trigger, better controls, and of course, fantastic takedown. The MSRP on the standard is $449, while the tactical is listed at $169. American Tactical has also released a new gun that is closer to the 1800s version of the tactical. To a Rogue Agent. This is an expansion of their cavalry line of shotguns, and I believe all of them are imported from Turkey. Correct me if I'm wrong on that. I've said this before on the show, but Turkey produces some decent quality yet affordable shotguns, and this could be another addition to that. The basics are that it's a side-by-side 12-gauge with external hammers, which are like, and 18.5-inch barrels. MSRP on this bad boy is just shy of $600. It's impossible to say without hands-on time with the gun whether or not it's going to be worth that much money. The engraving on the side is nice, but when it comes to break-action shotguns, money is made with the smoothness and fit.
At 1,000 feet, exit to the right.
The wood could be ugly and unfinished, but the action is perfect. It almost takes a hammer with the rest is like. This thing is definitely not a shotgun for everyone out there with its limited capacity and uses, but having another option for a classically styled 12-gauge is never a bad thing. We've got a ton of friendly fire questions again this week. The first one is from Matt Klaus on the TGC Facebook page, and he asks, will crotchety 1911 owners ever die off? Yes, they will, and they will be replaced with crotchety Glock 19 owners. Our next friendly fire question is from Eric Teal, and he asks, what is your number one unicorn gun? That's tough to say because it kind of changes from time to time, but right now I would have to say the Fallschirmjägerwehr 42, otherwise known as the FG-42. They were chambered in 8mm Mauser, fired up to 900 rounds per minute on the early models, and just straight up shenanigans. I love those things. They are not very common in private collections here in the U.S., and if you did find one, you better warm up the wallet because will not be cheap.
Exit to the right onto your state route 38 West.
Michael Drew, Roosevelt Road. He's a great guy. I met him in person once. Asked, what is the next big innovation you want to see from the firearms industry? I want to see us move into a new type of ammunition. I firmly believe that we will see very slow innovation trends until then. We've been using brass case ammo for so long, and it seems like every new version of that is just not very good, or it's really, really ridiculously expensive. It's going to take some major leaps from the bigger companies that will get behind stuff. Unless something gets accepted as quickly as it did with 300 Blackout, I'm not sure it's going to stick. Now, my friendly fire question to you guys, how often do you get out and actually put rounds through your gun? We're talking once a month, once a week maybe, or maybe just a few times a year. Let me know your thoughts in the comments down below. And hey, if you have a question you want answered here on TGC News, you can head over to theguncollector.com and send it to me on the friendly fire page. Grand CLP offers an entire lineup of non-toxic coolers and lubes with a certain shoe. You can use their bore and bolt to clean up carbon, fouling, or rust, and then follow it up with their CLP, or hot heavy applications, a hog grease, for before, during, and after the range. Find out what the nano-infused bio-friendly lineup for Grand CLP is all about over at GrandCLP.com. And before we go, I want to say a huge thank you to Magpul, Scalpel Arms, and anybody that checked out live auction that happened on Friday night. It was kind of a spur-of-the-moment idea that grew really, really fast. Friday night, we had a live auction on Facebook and raised over $3,000 for Texas Hurricane Relief. And we aren't going to give that money to some huge charity like Red Cross or some other charity where you don't really know where the money's going. Christian, the owner of Scalpel, not only did he design the mags that we were auctioning off, but he is also been down in the affected areas near Houston helping people, and that money will go straight to continuing to help those folks in need. Magpul was super generous as well and donated a bunch of magazines to help facilitate these efforts. Now, before you ask, we're definitely going to be doing this for the wildfires in Montana as well as the nonsense happening right now in Florida. Keep an eye on the TGC social media for info on that. And again, thank you to everyone that bought mags, shared the video, that helped us in any way, and they helped our countrymen in Texas. God guys, the amount of money we raised in such a short amount of time was absolutely incredible. So seriously, thank you. And that is it for this week's show. Guys, do not forget to get entered into the TGC Bacon Bash for every $5 you spend on TGCgear.com. Get an entry to this wild giveaway. Details are over there. And if you enjoyed this episode, hit that like button, share it with your friends. It's a massive bump. If you didn't, let me know why down in the comment section below. And if you haven't yet, please hit subscribe. Don't want to miss a single episode of this show and all the others that we make. And as always, thank you all for watching. I'll see you soon.
Said that the Book of Israel in 1948, the first Jewish nation since Rome conquered Jerusalem in the year 70, was nothing short of a miracle. Yet there's little doubt of the
Turn left. Ready.